Hi everyone and welcome back. It's Vicky here with a brand new product today. So Alter New has just released a new watercolor pan set. I'm going to unbox it so you can see what you get, how many colors and how they work. And I'm going to put them into use making a card so you can see this pan set in action. Now this is actually part of a blog hop, so if you want to get inspired, make sure to visit my blog and follow all the links. There are lots of inspiration and lots of giveaways along the way. So first let's take a look at the brush that comes in the set. So this is one of those watercolor brushes that you need to fill in the barrel, so it is a great set to have on the go. And this is a fine tip brush, so it's perfect for little details. Now of course you can use the lid as your mixing palette, and in the set there are 36 different colors in half pans, as you can see. You can take them out of the case, as you can see, and use them if you want to. And at the bottom there is the name of the color, so hopefully if they come up with replacements then you know which color you are out of. Now I took my time to create a very quick palette, so without names and anything, so that you can see how they work on watercolor paper. And here is a quick look. You get lots of blues, which I absolutely love. You get grays and browns and dark purples, as well as a beautiful range of pinks and reds, oranges, yellows and greens. Beautiful set, lots and lots of colors, and you can make even more colors if you mix up some of them. And after using them, I can say that they are very pigmented, and when they dry, they don't fade out as much as other watercolors. So the color that you apply on your paper is pretty much what you get when everything is dry. So now I'm going to have some fun watercoloring some of the flowers from this stamp set. This is from a previous release, which is called Cherished Memories. It has those beautiful flowers and leaves, as well as lovely sentiments. So I'm going to work on watercolor paper. I'm going to stamp my flowers and my leaves. And to stamp, I'm using permanent black ink by Alter New, which is going to make sure that these black lines are not going to smudge or smear when I go on top of them with my watercolors. I have sprayed water on top of my pans to activate them, and I will use greens and pinks mainly to color my flowers. I'm using the lid as a palette so that I can mix my colors there and water them down if I need to. The colors I used for my leaves are bamboo and forest glades. And here is something really awesome that I forgot to mention earlier. The colors of this pan set actually match the colors of the ink pads by Alter New, which means that there are so many different ways you can use this color matching attribute. For example, you can use one of those green shades that I work with now for the leaves and in an ink pad to stamp your sentiment, and everything is going to match perfectly on your final project. Now I'm coloring the flowers, and I used pink diamond, puffy heart and purple wine. Again, these colors exist as ink pads from Alter New as well. Now I find that using watercolors instead of alcohol markers is really forgiving, and it gives you great results really easy. So all I'm doing here is adding the darker color at the base of each petal, and then I am cleaning my brush and I'm using the watered down lighter color at the tip of each petal. Now I'm going to show you something that I usually do, which adds highlights on my project, and it's really easy. So I'm using a clean brush here with clean water, and I'm going to apply some water directly on my petals. This is going to reactivate the watercolor, and then I'm going to dab it with a cloth, which is going to remove some of the color, but it's going to give a beautiful highlighting there, nice and blended with the rest of the color of my petal. I do that pretty much on every watercolored image, and I'll do that for my leaves as well. It adds a touch of highlight on your projects. It turns them looking more dimensional, and of course you need to be working on watercolor paper to be able to lift enough color from your project. For the center of my flowers, I used Citrus Burst and Warm Sunshine. And once everything was colored, I used the matching dies to cut out the flowers and the leaves. So I'm going to place all the dies on top of my colored images. I'm going to secure them down with some purple tape and run them through my Big Shot. Now it's time to put everything together. As a lovely accent, I have added just a very thin strip of pattern paper with black and white stripes on one side of my panel. And now I'm using foam tape at the back and I'm sticking down my flowers and my leaves. And as I always say, flower cards are perfect for any occasion, so depending on the sentiment that you decide to stamp, you can turn it into any type of card. I decided to go with one lovely sentiment from the same stamp set as the flowers that say enjoy every moment, cherish every memory. I'm going to stamp that with black ink on one side of my card where I deliberately left enough space for that. And I'm going to finish off my card by adding some clear crystals, which are going to add a touch of shine and elegance. I'm going to stick this panel on top of a top folding card that's 4.25 by 5.5, and my card is finished. As always, you will find a full list of supplies down below in the description area, as well as on my blog. Don't forget that this is part of a blog hop, so visit my blog to enter the giveaway and to find all the links that you want to follow to join even more giveaways and get lots of inspiration. I hope you had fun, that you got inspired. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.